Hey there, welcome to another Photoshop tutorial from tutcast.com. And in today's tutorial, we're going to be creating a droplet. Now before we begin, what is a droplet? Well basically, a droplet acts like an icon on your desktop. And whatever images, whether it's one image or 10 images or 100 images, that you drag on top of that droplet or icon, it will apply a certain set of actions to those images that you assigned in Photoshop. Now it may sound a little bit confusing without actually seeing it, so let's begin and let's create a droplet. In front of us I have a folder of 10 images. Again, you can have one image, 10 images, or 500 images, it doesn't matter. And we're going to drag one of these images into Photoshop. And here we go, we have an image that's 1,000 pixels wide and somewhere around 500 pixels tall. Now let's say, for argument's sake, we wanted to decrease the size of all of our images by 50%. The first thing we need to do, we need to create an action. Now I've done a tutorial in the past on how to create an action, but for the sake of this tutorial, I will show you again. In our palettes at the right hand side, we have an actions tab. And if you don't have that, you can go up to Window and then click on Actions. That will show your actions palette. Now this will work on Photoshop CS4, which I'm in right now, or Photoshop CS3, and I'm pretty sure it'll work on Photoshop CS2 as well. So here's our actions panel right here, and to begin we have to create a new action. We're going to click on the new actions icon right at the bottom here, and we're going to name it Car Show, just for argument's sake, and click on Record. Basically anything we do now after we clicked on Record will be stored in that action. So here we go, we're going to go up to the top, click on Image, Image Size, and we're going to select Percent and decrease it by 50%. We're going to click OK. And you'll notice it's decreased that image by 50% exactly. Now you can use it as in pixels or percentage, doesn't really matter. Now if you wanted to, you can go ahead and also add some adjustments. So you can go to auto tone, you can add an auto contrast, an auto color, any adjustments you want, it'll apply it to all the images that you apply the actions to. And as you can see here, we have our auto tones, auto contrast, and auto colors, as well as the image size. So once we have those done, we're going to go ahead and save the image, which will also save it to the action. We're going to go to File, Save As, and we're going to save it to a new folder within that folder called Resized. Click on Create, and we're going to click on Save, Maximum Settings, click OK. So there we go, we have our action complete. We have it image sized, we have the auto tone, auto color, and auto contrast. So then we're going to go ahead and click on Stop. Now we'll save the action, it's complete, it's done, it's ready to go. So now we can go ahead and open every single image individually and apply this action to those images, but creating a droplet will be so much easier, and this is how we do it. With that action selected, we're going to go to File, Automate, and then click on Create Droplet, right there. And here is our Create Droplet dialog box. Now we have to choose where to save that droplet. I'm going to choose the desktop. I'm going to click on Desktop. I'm going to name it Car Show. Click on Save. And then we have to make sure that action is set to Car Show, which is the action that we just created. We're going to choose the destination where it's going to save the saved images that it resized. So we're going to click on Choose. It's going to save it to the resized folder, which we created a minute ago. Click on Choose. Override Action Save As command. That's good. Document name, we're going to keep it as the original document name, and the extension. We're going to save it for Windows, Mac, and Unix. And then we should be fine, and we're going to click on OK. Now we're going to go ahead and hide Photoshop. And as you can see on our desktop, we have a new icon. And that is our droplet icon. So basically, watch this. Here's our resized folder, as you can see here. We're going to open it in a new window. And we're going to drag the remaining images that were not saved onto our Car Show droplet. And it's going to launch Photoshop and it's going to automatically resize and apply all those adjustments to the photos we just dragged on top of the droplet. And there we go, it's done. We're going to hide Photoshop one more time. And as you can tell, it's placed them inside the resized folder. And if we right click and click Get Info, it has decreased it by exactly 50%. Now again, you can go back into Photoshop and apply any sort of actions or adjustments to the images, save them as a droplet, whatever you want. And one more time, you can do one photo, 10 photos or 500 photos, it works exactly the same. Saves you a lot of time if you want to do the exact same thing to a whole bunch of photos. So I hope you learned something in this tutorial. I know I spoke really quickly. I'm just realizing that right now. You may have to watch it again. But I hope you learned something. Hope you apply it to your projects. Head over to tutcast.com. Subscribe to our RSS feed. We're always releasing tutorials early. We're also starting to get Flash tutorials coming in. Whole bunch of good stuff. And until next time, this is Howard from tutcast.com. Take care.